Hello, you Dirty Potters. How are you today?
So today is gonna be kind of a shorter and weirder episode. Long story short, I'm gonna be doing a pit fire today because I made two very large, like 20-inch plates on the YouTube channel. You might have seen that video already, but I don't wanna glaze these plates. These plates are super big. I'm doing too many glaze experiments at the morning. I'm dealing with a bunch of glazy stuff, and I just don't feel like actually firing them and trying to sell them on my website. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pit fire them. But why would I do a pit fire without inviting some pottery friends over, right? So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna fire these two very, very large pieces and see what we get out of the pit fire. And we're gonna go get my friend Natasha and my friend Lindsay. You haven't met Natasha yet, but don't worry, she's super cool. I like her a lot, and you probably would have met more of her by now if it wasn't for the virus we do not talk about unless we get demonetized. As for the stuff that we're gonna burn today, we're probably gonna be burning like a lot of bark and trees and leaves. It's fall right here right now in Sacramento. Well, I guess it's fall everywhere technically. Smud in Sacramento anyway has to go around clipping all the trees because we got a lot of trees. They basically put them in this big pile for anyone to just take. So I'm just gonna go over to Smud, pick up the pile of that stuff, like two big buckets of it, and just burn that stuff along with any other things that are safe to burn in my backyard. Actually, you know what? Instead of like videotaping myself just grabbing leaves off the ground, I'm just there. Now, instead of watching me go get stuff in my car, which would take like 5 minutes extra of the video, we just skip that step. I just put them on the ground there. You happy now, you little loser? I also have to go get Lindsay because she doesn't own a car, and I assume many of you don't want to see me picking up Lindsay. So, okay, so we have the plates, we have Lindsay, we have myself, we have the materials, we have a lot of carbonates and oxides actually. I went through my stuff the other night and decided to like reorganize all my chemicals, and it turns out I found a bunch of stuff that I know what it is, I just don't need it. I'll never need nickel and black, like copper carbonate to mix, like I just don't need it, you know what I mean? So we're gonna be using those today. We have lots of kerosene, and I'm pretty sure Natasha's in the backyard.
Pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
I hope she's back there. Say hello, Natasha.
Hello, Natasha.
That's literally what she said.
Yeah, but context.
Hello, I'm Natasha.
Oh, good. Hi. This is Natasha. I'm sure many of you have seen
Oh, this is for the video.
Of course. That's why I have a record.
That makes sense. Hi, I'm Tasha from Tasha Throws Raw. I throw pottery, and I'm here to do a pit fire with Dante and Lindsay with Earth Nation Ceramics and Lindsay M. Milton.
Oh, all right.
Milton. Damn, it's so close.
So close. Lindsay M. Dillon.
Milton.
Would you mind showing me some of the pieces that you have to fire today?
But they're poo.
No, they're not poo, they're good.
They're my wobbly pieces that I just threw in.
Your pieces are good.
This is an off piece. This is a planter that came out a little wobbly, and I was like, I don't know what to do with it, so let's throw it in a pit and fire it in a pit that is firing with fire.
You good?
Yes.
So I don't know if you guys can see it, but the pit fire is kind of warming up right now. I haven't used it in probably like a year, so I decided to clean it out by just catching everything on fire. Fire, pro tip, cleans everything. So we're probably gonna light this up real quick. We're gonna stack our stuff in there, and we're gonna pour ourselves some tea and just kind of chill, and hopefully you can join us.
Ryan Little.
So why are we soaking these pieces in kerosene, Dante?
Sometimes it makes a rainbow effect.
Okay.
And I haven't got it under control yet. I just know that sometimes I put it on there and it does the thing.
So we're having uncontrolled rainbows. How do you feel about this? Oh, cool. All right, so what else do we have in here?
Well, okay, so for those of you who haven't watched my other pit fire videos, what I usually do is I roll up, as you probably already saw me do when I was editing it, I roll up carbonates and oxides and colorants and pigments into these little like bounty towels, which I call oxide burritos.
Love that.
I put them next to the pieces so that the pieces get hot enough to where their pores open up, it'll accept the color, and I just put the color directly next to it. The kerosene is just to help it burn since it's kind of cold right now, and also the kerosene sometimes gives it really nice colors. So that's just essentially what I do. I just have to be careful to not put too much in here because if it gets too hot too quick, it'll explode the pieces.
No!
But just for anyone who asks, because sometimes this question happens in the comments below, all of these pieces have been bisqued. None of these pieces are, throw these and dry them out.
Yeah.
You have to put bisque work inside of a pit fire in order for it to survive the majority of the time. And it's heavily suggested that they all be at least clay with some kind of grog in it, even though I've totally gotten away with porcelain before. The grog really just helps stuff stick together and not break.
Okay.
Granted, I've done porcelain before, but I've usually like burnished my porcelain before I did that kind of stuff.
Ah, yas. I gotta back up for this. Look at that. Look at that manly pose.
Stop it.
Some of y'all are oil painters out there, and you also follow Dante, which would be interesting for an oil painter to be following a pottery YouTube channel. But if this is the case, then I beseech thee to paint an oil painting of that pose that Dante just did. Yes, yes. Unfortunately, I can't pay you, so maybe don't work for free. So, you know.
Tomorrow.
Ryan Little.
I actually like these. These didn't come out too bad at all, especially this one. Got some really nice kind of
rainbow color right there on the side. If you can, when I seal this up with some sealer, it's gonna look really, really nice for this one. This one, I'm surprised it actually survived, but it didn't get any real color. Like, I put it directly in the middle of the kiln and it got like maybe a little bit of color right there. It didn't get too much. The saddest thing about this pit fire is that my two super big, like 21 inch plates didn't survive the process. Although it did get some really nice color. These would have been fantastic if they survived, but sadly they didn't survive. I want to say, like, in the middle of the night when I checked on it, I had already seen this piece chipped off from right here, so like this was already done as is, so we're gonna have to chuck this one. And I was really kind of banking on this one, which I was hopeful for, because I looked in the kiln and I saw it got all of this really, really nice color. Look, there's some nice kind of bluish right there, there's some metallic right there, it caught some of the pit fire smoke right here, there's some nice yellow here. It would have been really nice, but unfortunately it didn't survive either. Part of me was kind of like, oh, I can keep this. I can keep this and still make it into something. You know, a tiny part of me was like, I can do kintsugi on this. Like, I can repair this with gold. But number one, I don't have that much gold on me right now to repair like a 21 inch plate. And number two, you have to have the ability to like stick it back together with real gold. Otherwise, you're just doing it with like that fake mica powder that every potter knows. It's like, that's not kintsugi. That's not real gold. That's just yellow powder with glue mixed in. So firstly, I don't want to do it the fake way and I don't have enough gold. And secondly, there's way too many, it's done now. I mean, it's not like I was going to sell on my website anyway. Nobody's buying like super huge artistic plates for me. Most people want to buy like mugs and artistic things, but I want to do it for me. Okay, I want to do it for me. I want to do it for my soul for once. I'm tired of doing everything for money. The thing that I am happy about though is that all of my friends' stuff survived, which is like, that's, I would much rather my friends have some pit fire stuff for their experience. Like, here's Lindsay's bowl. Here's Tasha's stuff right here. She actually got some good rainbow color right there on the outside, if you can kind of see it. So I'm actually pretty happy that their pieces survived over mine, because I can redo those big plates in my own pit fire that I built. I can do it myself. They don't have a pit fire, so it's way better for their stuff to survive than my stuff. I can redo mine, they can't like do their stuff on a dime. But I'm actually fairly happy with this one right here. This one got a lot of good color. There's a tiny bit of black down there, tiny bit of blue, some yellow, some green. The color smoke, oh look, that's so nice. I'm probably gonna seal this up and put a picture on the gram just so that you guys can see it in all its magnificence. Plus, I don't think I really make shapes like this too often. Like, they're not functional. You know, you put one flower in there and you're done. But those pieces over there, they gotta go in the trash. I honestly think what happened is that it's been raining for the past like couple of days in Sacramento. So everything was super cold, everything was super wet, and then I decided to start a fire, and that was a contradiction in heat and cold, and that probably gave these plates some good thermo shock over here. And along with the thermo shock, it's still super cold. So in the middle of the night, that plate probably cracked. But when I was lighting the fire with the kerosene, that plate most likely cracked. I really think that's purely thermo shock, like that entire process. They're too big and they're too thin to survive that process. Not to mention the yard that I pick up most of my materials, because Smud kind of supplies me with this stuff. They just leave it out in a big yard, which means these were all wet when I put them in, which is probably why I had such a problem starting the fire and keeping it going. So this was really just a bad circumstance of weather. I think if it was warmer, or maybe we did it on a day like today where the sun's kind of out and everything, then maybe those plates would have survived. But no, it clearly rained while the pit fire was going, you know, which is weird because I live in California and that almost never happens. Anyway, this pit fire was a little bit of a fail for me, but I really enjoyed having some company over for like the first time in a year so far. So thank you, Dirty Potters, for joining me today. If you'd like to see any of my actual artwork, the links are always down below for your beautiful potter eyes to see. The Instagram, my Facebook page, my own website, along with my blog, it's all down there. You're smart enough, you know exactly where the links are. You know all the buttons to click. You got higher than a double digit IQ. You go do the clicky button thing. With that being said, I love your Dirty Potter faces, and I will see you guys next week.
Thank you for your patronage.